All right, everyone, we are here right now. I always say we are here. Okay, we're excited. It's the next beautiful morning from Thanksgiving, and I have my new co-host, one of our guest hosts that's going to be here. We have Nivea Shepherd. She's our growing young Black woman, and she's always going to do a wonderful segment called Questions from a Young Black Woman. And so would you say hello to everyone today?
Hi, everyone. I am so excited to be here.
We're going to get her own mic. I'm still getting everything together for the podcast, so I'm definitely going to get her own mic so she could be able to be more vocal. She's going to be talking to, interviewing other young girls her age and bringing back that information, recording them. We're going to see those videos. We're going to really get this thing going because we want to change. Our purpose and my purpose, I know, in life is to help heal the Black woman's womb. And that has to do with inner healing of the trauma and the things we experience in this country, the abuse, the verbal abuse, the emotional abuse, and the abuse against our creation and how God has created us. So I'm so excited. And then all women are welcome though, because everybody needs healing. And I know there's other cultures that experience this kind of pain and suffering as a Black woman has. So at the end of the day, I'm excited, I am blessed, and I'm grateful. So let me start off with prayer, and then we're gonna get right into this segment. And also, let's go live on Facebook. So I'm gonna go ahead and go live right now, and we could go ahead and show our friends and our family what's going down with Growing Up Black Women as we go live. So patiently wait, and then I'll start off with prayer. I hope that you guys can still hear me clearly as we're trying to go live. This is our first time doing it. Let's see, live. Let's see if it's going live. We already logged in. I don't know why. Okay, it's going through. Go live on Facebook. We want everybody to know that Growing Up Black Women is our new show. Podcast, and here we go. Podcast. GYBW. I just make up songs. GYBW. Man, it is. And you know what the craziest is? This is also Black Friday.
Oh my gosh, no way.
Yeah, we're
about to go shopping.
We're in Black Friday. And I don't know how long this is. You know what? I'm not tripping about going live because we're just so awesome. We don't really need to go live. I mean, we'll see. I wish people could see us. Yeah. But we need to work on, I'm still working on how to get that connected. Let's just do what we do best. Let's show everybody us right now. Let's not be concerned.
Sure?
Yeah. We'll go live another time. Choose what you want to post live. Okay. See, it says choose where you want to post live. Okay.
It's still loading.
Yeah, we'll go live once we start. But let me go ahead and pray, because first and foremost, this is We Rebuild Movement. This is Growing Young Black Women, and it's all started and founded and sourced with Jesus Christ as our Savior. He saved us from our sins, and we're grateful to have Him as our source, and we're humbling ourselves before Him all the time before we start, because He is our King. And he is who we serve. So Father God, we just thank you right now. We thank you that you've given us the opportunity to expand and amplify our gifts. God, I am gifted in speaking life into people. I'm gifted in using your words that you give to me, Father God, to bring healing and not to bring anything else but your love and healing, oh God. So Lord, use my mouth this day, Father God, as I speak life into all the growing young Black women out there in this world. They're all over. They're all over the world, God, that needs to be reached, that needs to be healed, that's been traumatized and hurt during this 400s of years of suffering. And so now it's time for the healing. And God, I thank you for the Holy Spirit that has came into my spirit and to everybody else saying it's time for your healing. And we're grateful, Lord. And we just want you to bless this podcast this day, and that everything that we speak is guided by you, and we enjoy it from this day forth. In Jesus' name, amen. All right.
Thanks to the man.
Thanks to the man. Okay. So I was going to share my screen with and try to go live. We'll try to go back onto that later, but I have so many things I want to talk about. And now that we have our younger part, a lot of people don't know, growing up Black women, we started in, what was it? Like in last May. It was been almost a year and a half. It was last May. So it was May 2019. But our first session was in September of 2019.
Yeah.
And it was amazing. The topic that we first did, and we've been doing this for over a year. The first topic we did, we had about 25 girls show up, and it was on igniting the champion within. And so this podcast, I knew that after we did, and we had a grad, you were a graduate. How did you enjoy it?
Yeah, it was really, really, it was very fun and educational. I could say for myself that I was really proud of myself that I got through it, and I learned more about my culture and what I need to be a champion and a growing young Black woman throughout all the stuff that has happened to us and just everything with COVID-19 and not be able to see our families and Black Lives Matter. I think that just helping me ignite my champion within and tell me that I am a beautiful Black woman and nobody can say anything different.
Amen. And what did we do? You remember how the Esther, we did the whole segment on replacing the Vashti and receiving the Esther, that whole Esther anointing. Like, do you remember anything that you learned from that? I mean, I know it was about a year ago, but do you remember how that was effect, like how that strengthened you?
It strengthened me in a number of ways, and it strengthened me in knowing that I can, it strengthened me in knowing that I need to always take care of my body, lotion it, oils, and I had to take care of my hair, and knowing that I always had to go to God first before going to anybody else and making my decisions, especially a big decision as helping my country.
Amen. Yeah, well, Esther did that, and so we were teaching that, like, we taught that there's no other crown that anybody could put on your head other than that is more important than the crown of Christ that he puts on our head, and that we are royal already, and that we don't need, if someone else's crown doesn't mean you take off the crown that God put on you and then put theirs on. When you put their crown on, you're going to feel humiliation, you're going to feel disappointment, you're going to feel abuse comes in because you're putting on the crown that they think that who you are or who they want you to be. And that's not how it works. Yeah. They might like some things about you, but they're going to have their own visualization of who they want you to be and who they're relating you to or who they grew up at seeing or watched as a woman. And that's not what Esther did. Esther never took her crown off as a Jewish, faith-believing woman of God. She kept her crown on. And Mordecai made sure that she remembered that. Like, don't forget who you are first. Keep your crown on from Christ, and then you keep that on and you present yourself. And if they're going to honor that more than they even honor whatever crown they try to put on you. Don't ever take off your crown, woman of God. Keep your crown on. Know who you are. Know that God has crowned you with his glory, that you're beautifully made. He sees you as his bride. You're gorgeous. And nobody, no man, no women, no, not your mom, not your sisters, can ever take that crown off. Only you can. And when you do, and you put the crown that they're visualizing you as, you're going to feel the pain of it. It's awful. Because eventually it may feel all good at the beginning, then eventually there's criticism, there's disrespect, there's manipulation, all kinds of things to make you something that you're not. And you are purposely and wonderfully made to serve Jesus and to have him as your king and nobody else. And so I really love that you had said those things about those classes. So we did like I think it was about 8 weeks.
Oh my gosh, yeah, I don't think it was eight.
It was longer. Yeah, because we do a graduation and we do it. Listen, we're making this, we're gonna try to run this everywhere. And when we do these programs, but because of COVID, Lord put on my heart to start this podcast because the COVID is gonna be a lot of issues of us having these workshops and stuff. So we're gonna try to do it again, another workshop, and just maybe mask everybody up, which I don't really want to wear a mask.
As long as they want to.
I don't want to force anybody, but you know, I think God has definitely given us the opportunity to still do a workshops and stuff through this podcast. And so we are excited about that. And you can go to our website, www.werebuildmovement.com. And that's where you can find all the GYBW information. You'll see all of the stuff that we've been doing to young women all throughout the years. We had a young women's summit that was dynamic. And we also do programs for growing young Black women. Don't ever think that because we're out here healing the growing young Black women doesn't mean we are not in need of the men. Hey, the men are their rib. We are their side, and that means we stand with them. We stand equal to them, and we understand our role to them, and that they are highly needed. But we are highly different as well. And there's a different way we heal. There's a different way we receive. There's a different way we do things. We don't have to do it the way the men do it to be successful. You do it in your beautiful charm, elegance, and grace. You know, Esther didn't go to the king. If you guys know anything about the story, look in the book of Esther, chapter 7. And she didn't go to the king, barging through the door with a sword and saying, "You better free my people." No, because that's not the way women should do. Now, don't get it wrong. There's women warriors. I consider myself as a lady warrior, but I'm a lady first. And so she came in there with elegance and charm to the king and out of respect and order. And so women, get what you need to get done. Go after what you want to go after. But do not ever neglect the anointing that's already on you with elegance, charm, beauty, love, and kindness and gentleness. That is one of the things that enemies tried to steal for Black women through slavery. We had to do jobs the men had to do. We were not supposed to be sweat of the brow out there and doing that groundwork like that. It was for men, but they threw Black women. They wouldn't throw their own women. They wouldn't even have their own women doing stuff. Now, if we have to and there's no men around, so be it. You got to do what you to help the family, but still doesn't mean you throw away your elegance. Doesn't mean you throw away your grace. Doesn't mean you take off your crown and put on the crown of a man. No. God will see you through. God will bring someone in your life. He will bring someone around or near. There's plenty of men in the world that are not your husband that could just be there to help do those things. And you stay in your elegance. Proverbs 31 woman, she did a lot of things. They show all these things that she did. Yet she stayed in her elegance. She wore a royal robe, which was, you know, purple royalty. So just keep that in mind, growing up Black women. So this is totally not our topic today, but I'm just so excited because it reminded me, man, our programs are still dynamic and they're effective. And Nivea is going to be one of our key ambassadors that is going to go out, interview young girls and ask questions to them. We're gonna start recording that, getting segments of it and just having her, you know, really be the voice until we could do some more workshops or we could have other graduates. We have two other ambassadors in Arizona, or three others that have been solid. But, you know, like I said, there's been a lot of changes. So because of the COVID, so we can't get them actively involved like we'd love to, but God is working. He's always will. So the segment today we were supposed to be talking about is Thanksgiving cleaning. How did you feel about Thanksgiving yesterday?
I guess it was really good. I loved the cooking and especially the eating part. I ate a lot and then I ate more and then I ate peach cobbler and then I was just full and I felt like all last night I wanted to eat more, but I couldn't.
But do you so like fun. Your mom's peach cobbler?
Yes. Yes, I do.
Nivea, how old are you?
I am 11. I just turned 11 on the 15th of November.
Okay. Okay. That's wonderful. What grade are you in?
I'm in sixth grade right now. So I'm just gotten sixth grade. So I'm like not even halfway through, but I'm doing pretty good.
Awesome. Awesome. Okay. So if anybody can see our kitchen right now, I usually cook while I clean. I mean, clean while I cook, but Thanksgiving, I can't do that. I'm so exhausted. And so we don't do the cleaning until
2 days later.
No, the morning, at least today. Well, I'm not going to leave that kitchen dirty until, you know, the morning. And so the hardest part, and this is why this is an awesome segment, because the hardest part is literally, let me move this mic because I keep turning my head. That's better for us to share. The hardest part is, I would say, the cleaning after you've done so much eating and cooking and preparing. Preparing and cooking is so much fun, and then you're tired. And then you're like, I do not want to clean anything. I've done so much work.
You just want to let somebody else do it.
Yeah, you wish you had like someone else to come and clean it out, you know, and you prepared. And I said to Nivea, this is a wonderful topic to talk about because I think it's a spiritual thing too. Like how we prepare, we work hard on something, and there's things that's left out or left over that after you've done so well and did the job and succeeded, there's still things that came in there with it that needs to get cleaned out. And so in everything that is good, like it says, God says that the rain falls on the good and the bad. So either way, there's sometimes we are growing next to things that are not so good, and we still got to clean it out. So like when I look at the turkey and I think about all the food and the wonderful time, wasn't it fun? I mean, what did it feel like yesterday having your family and eating and stuff like that?
It just felt really replenishing. Mm-hmm. And it felt good to see that everybody was happy and having a good time. We were all together, no arguing for first time in a million years. And I just thought it was great that we all ate and had a good time.
Yeah. I think that not only that, there's things that Thanksgiving brings, I love that it brings the good and the love and the sharing, but then we find out and see the things that we have to clean out. There's relationships, there's issues that we realize now that we came together at the table that haven't been cleaned out, that haven't been addressed, that frustrations and angers that people have amongst each other and they're still holding on to. And it's up to us, not for you to address it, but also to think about, is it worth it? Is it worth me just going ahead and cleaning myself and clean it out, get out of my system, or just keeping it dirty and then still eating a meal with somebody and I'm still have this in my heart about them? That I'm still hurting about them. I refuse to get healing. And it's our own responsibility. It is your own responsibility to ask God to help heal. You lean in his strength. This is the weakness of it. That when it says in the word of God, my weakness, and God says, well, my strength, I become strong in your weakness, because you're submitting it to him. You don't think that you don't think that you're supposed to go and, you know, do it yourself, but you know that you need help in this. So there are definitely your family issues that come up during Thanksgiving, you know, and I think we had some too. And we're still healing. You know, we're still healing. There's a lot of pain, but we're not going to sit around and not clean the house. You know, and that is the most important thing. Like this morning, we're going to go right now after this podcast, because we still haven't cleaned the kitchen. Maybe it's like, I'm not doing it. You're not. Yes, you are. You're cleaning up with mommy.
Can the boys do that?
No, put your mouth on the mic. We can't hear you.
Can't the boys do that?
No, they are going to help. Yes, the boys are going to help. They're going to clean the living room. But What I love about this opportunity is to get you guys to start to think, as growing young Black women, that there's people that have hurt you. There's people that young, you know, not just being young, but even as you grow up. I think this segment and every segment we do here is for all women of all ages, but we want to make sure the young women are invited as well, and to target on them, because there's fought, you've had men hurt you. And I think that is the hardest part, is when a man who is supposed to be your side, you know, your equal, you were created from him, that same being hurts you. And so there's fathers, there's husbands, there's boyfriends. And then at that point, our hearts get so caught up and broken that we don't go to the healer that heals the broken heart. And then we come to Thanksgiving dinners and eat, and yet we're still eating on top of dirty plates. You know, we're not eating on anything that is clean, and you're sitting around eating and you're sitting there bitter, cruel, you know, rude, you know, easily tempered. And then you're not enjoying the beautiful anointing that comes with the family love and the joy and the peace, because you're holding on to the past, you're holding on to the pain, and you don't want to clean your plate. You don't want to clean the plate before you eat, and then you don't want to clean it after you eat either. So just be aware that this is a time of cleaning too. Thanksgiving is a time to clean your house. It's a time to clean your temple. It's a time to reflect and say, is it worth for me to hold that on against that person? Or is it more worth for me to enjoy the love that brings with that person? Is that person so, whatever he did to hurt me, can I get healing from God and forgive? And then is the forgiveness more enjoyable than me holding on to this bitterness? Because that part never gets healed if you don't forgive. And you're sitting there bitter, angry, and it's not worth it. So I just want to say to everyone here on this podcast, enjoy Thanksgiving, enjoy the love, but make sure you got a clean plate. Make sure that after you eat, you clean it up too. And I'm talking about clean up inside your heart. Go to Yahshua, who says he draws near to the brokenhearted, and he comforts our wounds. So go near to him and ask him, God, I got an issue with this person. This person hurt me. And he can show you what things you've done as well. And when you see that, surrender it to him and ask for forgiveness. And then reconcile that relationship with that person. Be kind, find a way to start new. God is always trying to do new things. He's not trying to keep you in the past. He don't even stay. He's a creator. He changes. He doesn't change. He's always the same God, but he always creates. He's always doing something new. So he doesn't want you to stay in the past. He wants you to follow the things that protect you, follow the laws that protect you, but he doesn't want you to stay where you're unprotected. And that's in pain. That's in fear. That's in, you know, lies and confusion. He wants you to stay in his love, what gives you peace, joy. What's this fruit of the spirit?
Peace, joy, love, kindness, goodness, self-control, long-suffering, so on and so forth.
But doesn't that make fill your heart?
Yeah.
It fills your heart and it teaches you. And don't hold on. You've got to speak it out. We were talking about things in the past. How did that help you when you were hurting about certain people and that hurt you? What did you do to get some things cleaned out?
I guess what I did the most was talk about it. It always just lifts a big weight off your shoulders. If you just talk about it, you don't have to talk to anybody else. You can just go in your room and talk to God about it. Write it in your journal. It'll make you feel so much better. I feel like you had like a million weights on your back, and then it's like 5 million came off.
I agree. I think I didn't learn that, and I'm so grateful I was able to show you that too. But I didn't learn that till I was in my late 20s. So it was huge changing for me to write things out, to talk about it. I do agree with counseling. If you couldn't do it at Thanksgiving dinner, and to clear things up with the people that you love that's hurt you. Because it's always, I mean, Joseph, it was his brothers that hurt him the most, broke his heart the most. It's your family that's going to hurt you the most, the ones closest to you. And yet we don't reconcile. We don't talk it out. We don't write it out. We don't do any of those things. So I really, really advise that if you can't even talk to that person about it, you could go talk to someone, like, of course, God first. And God has beautiful minister counselors out there that will help you talk it out. That's what counseling is. It's not to say that you're crazy. It's not to say that you're psycho or anything like that. It's to say that I can help you talk this out, you know? And that's, I've done counseling. I have no shame in it. I'm grateful for it because I found a way to get healed through Christ, and Christ opened up the doors that I, or walls that I was creating around my heart, and to make me stony hearted. And now my heart is a heart of flesh. It's loving, it's kind. And when people come and still hurt me, I'm thankful that I can feel the hurt too, because you could get so stony hearted, you can't even feel the hurt when someone's trying to hurt you. And then you turn into something that you're not. I'm a gentle being. I'm a woman. I'm emotional. And if you're not feeling your emotions as a woman of God, then as a creator, as God has created us to be, we're supposed to be having emotions. If you're not feeling emotions, that means something has happened to you that you're stony. Okay. Men are not like us. We're supposed to have these emotions. Why? For our children, to be able to be nurturing and gentle with them. But if you are so much in pain and you don't want to clean it out, you have turned into someone that you're not created to be. You've turned into a person with a lack of emotions, which will eventually consume you into the stony hearted, hard person. And it totally takes all your femininity away. It take it all away. Now you're acting like, you know, I don't even know, because I don't even think men are consumed into so much lack of emotion like that, because men do have emotions too. But you're turning into a monster. And that's not what God creates. Everything he creates is beautiful. There's nothing evil that he creates. So I want to keep that in mind, because I remember being that way where I couldn't even cry, because I couldn't even tap into that kind of emotion, because I've been so stony from what had happened to me as a child. And then when I finally grew out of it, when I finally wrote, did all the reading and writing and getting closer to God, and this was all before I got married. So I'm grateful that I did this so I wouldn't bring that into my marriage. And so it was still a process of getting me in order, and God got me in order. But I want to tell you guys, don't go that route. If you're feeling absolutely no emotion to things, that's because God has literally been removed out of your life, and he is now second to this idol stone that you created in your heart. And now he comes lower than that, and this stone is that you create in your heart now is above it. So now you are this, you worship this thing, this being that is by your own hands, that it has no emotion, that is boss lady, mean to everybody, money, and there's no nurturing. You have no relationship with your children, no love with your children. Just, you think you're worse than a man. A lot of people get mad and say that some black women or think they're a man, and no, they're worse than a man when they get to that place. It's beyond a dualistic spirit. You're now this entity that has stoned into an idol that it's really hard to get away from, because you didn't want to clean house. You didn't want to reveal to God your pain. You didn't want to cry it out. You didn't want to shout, and you didn't want to receive. You didn't want to receive. You wanted to hide. So woman of God, growing your black women, clean house. It's time to clean house, clean up after turkey, you know, clean up with your family. We had some family discussions the day before Thanksgiving, or the few days before Thanksgiving, and even though it hurt, it felt good to get it out. how we feel. And even though we were hurt, what some people said to us, it felt good to get it out, because you don't, if it's out, then it can't turn into stone. All right. All right. So that's one part of our segment. We have a little short segment for Nivea Shepherd now, where she's going to ask questions. And we call this part of the segment questions from the growing young, or questions from a young Black woman.
Okay. I think this will be a great time to get on Facebook Live.
So okay. Let's try to get on Facebook Live. Yeah. That's a good idea.
So then people can live put in answers.
Yeah. That's a good idea. All right. So are we live now? Let's see. I did it again. Maybe I shouldn't have did it again.
No.
Oh, this is the second one. No, I don't want to do that one.
We'll exit out.
All right. All right. Next. Sharing the time. Next. And I think we share our screen then now, right?
Yeah, probably. Absolutely.
That's so sad, you know. The guy from did you know he passed away?
No way.
Yeah.
Oh, that's
from
so
Jeopardy. Yeah. He's really awesome. Let's see. He's going.
Well, let me put out some doo 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 sound.
Close some of this stuff up so we can move faster. Bear with us. We're going to put this screen on until we can get going and see what happens. Let's share our screen. I don't want to share our screen yet. Let's see. Still going. Oh, we're entering. Yes, look, it's working.
Yeah.
Live streaming preview. It's working. Yeah, you're right. So we want to do this. You're so smart, Nivea. Mm-hmm. So then people can ask questions to you. So we're going to be like, hey, everybody, get on right now. And this is questions from the young Black woman. And I want you to ask these people questions that you have too. Like, you know, not just from what other young girls or other young people, but ask, this will be fine, because this is what I didn't have. Like, you know, Black families, they didn't let young children have a voice or a choice, and I think that's wrong. I think children should always have a choice. I think that it's
when they're given one.
Yeah, it's certain choices we give them, though, you know, like they have a choice. These are your two choices, or these are your three choices. I'm not going to give you to say that you could choose. But I think your voice is important. I think the reason why we had to do that, where we didn't let you guys have a voice as a child growing up, because of the society. Governmentally, there was slavery. And if your child spoke or spoke their own thoughts, your child could die. Yeah. If you're still thinking that slave kind of mentality, then your child is not going to create, your child is not going to think that the world is their, under their dominion. So that's what they did to us on purpose as slaves, to make us think that we can't have the great things. And if you think that way as a child, that you don't have choices, that you don't get to choose to love God, it's a choice to have a relationship with God. You don't have to be forced to love God. It's a choice. And everything that we teach you guys is for you to see the difference and choose to want to receive it or not, and see if that is true knowledge. But this is one of the reasons why I really go against the slave. I have my book called The Slave Mind, The Mind of God. That's one of the reasons I went against it the most, is because it says that we're live, it just keeps floating.
Yeah, we just gotta wait. Slow.
Okay, so we're just gonna keep waiting right here. But it says preparing. So we're about to go live. All right, good. So it says live, but it's preparing up there. That's cool.
Let me see if I can catch it on the phone.
But it says it's preparing. So it's,
I know, but if I find it on the phone, I can watch.
Oh, okay, cool. But this is a definitely, I'm going to close this one out though so I can prepare better. This is definitely why I think it's so important to have you on this show, is because your voice matters. And like when they say, you know, Black Lives Matters or whatever, you know, and I you know, I'm not trying to do any kind of, you know, distinction. I'm just talking about the statement, not the organization. Black, our lives as a Black person matters. Okay. Your life as a child matters. As a Black child, as a growing young Black child matters. And how that matters is understanding that we can hear your voice, that your opinion matters, and that yet it may not be, there would be a right timing to give it, but it's done in a respectable way. And the questions you ask are important. And see, those voices, as growing up as a child in the Black homes, I'm talking about generations there. They weren't allowed to talk, to have a voice. And they saw this as a way of keeping them safe, but it really hurt them to stop thinking great about this stuff. It hurt them because they did not have a, you know, children did not have a dream. Now I can't have, if my voice, if you don't respect my voice, you're not gonna respect my dream. Why? Because I didn't speak my, I didn't speak my voice, my dream out. I couldn't speak it out. I couldn't vocal it out. And it says in the word of God that your tongue is life or death. Well, if you can't speak life on it, then you're not going to create great things for it. Okay, let's see. I think we're on right now. Let's see. Let me go back to this. Welcome to live, producer next. I think we might be on. New stream key. What is this? Use camera. Choose how you want to start setting up your live video. Stream key?
I really don't know. I never do Facebook Live.
I don't know either. We'll just use the stream key. See how live video performing in real time. Manage your live video.
Just press next.
Done.
What account are you using? Using this account to do a live?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, waiting for live video. Do I have to do something on the other side? Do I have to share the screen? It says it's recording. Waiting for live video. No, I don't want it to be only me. It's locked. It says only me. Bear with us. We're still recording. We know it. Okay, great. We go public. This is the first time we went live, and it was my wonderful daughter's idea. She was, so we're just trying to get this stuff together. Next time it'll be a lot easier, quicker. This is our first time doing it.
Let's see.
This is not gaming. Why does it say gaming?
Oh, since we're not live on, we need the video on. We don't have the video on though. Okay.
What's on?
The video.
How to get the video on?
Try to go to event logs. See what that did. Oops, that
one. Oh, maybe I need to do it again. Live on Facebook again.
Yeah, just go on the Facebook again. I could try and do it from the phone.
Mm-hmm. You could, yeah, put that on. You can go live there too. Just put start live video. And then put the pin thing down. Let's see. Oh yeah, wonderful. Okay. All right. Well, we try to do live from the computer through Zoom and take this down. Throw that out. Are we live right now?
Yeah, okay. We're live.
So we were trying to go live from Facebook through our Zoom, and it wasn't working. You'll still see this recording though. But this is Growing Young Black Women, Thanksgiving, cleaning house after Thanksgiving. That's what we called it. But we're not just talking about cleaning the house, because it is awful to clean the house. But we're talking about cleaning on the inside. So we already went on that whole part. Please go to our podcast to watch that part of the video. But now we're in the segment with Nivea Shepherd, and it's the part of the segment of the podcast is called Questions from a Young Black Woman. And so Nivea is a Growing Young Black Woman. She's our ambassador for GYBW, and she has some questions to ask you guys that's live on Facebook. Please get on and respond, and then I will answer them as well. Okay, so what are some of your questions?
Okay, my first question is to all the Black women out there. What is the most thing that has been helping you throughout this thing? And what's the most inspiring thing that has happened throughout all the whole COVID-19 thing? I don't care what it is, music, dancing, people who have inspired you. Just want you guys to go in the comments and tell me all of those people. Tell all these things.
Great idea. So please, we're waiting for you guys right now. Go, you know, this is GYBW podcast. We're on live on Facebook, and we want you guys to comment right now and literally tell us what things have inspired you during COVID. And since this is the next day of Thanksgiving, there should have been something that you could have said that strengthened you. So can I ask you that question so far? If some things that's inspired me until someone responds.
Yeah.
Because we haven't had anybody come in yet, but.
Let me see if I can invite people to your phone.
Okay. So what things that has inspired me? So I would say I listen to, okay. So a lot of people, probably have had a lot of time. Let me put this mic closer to me now. Has had a lot of time now that we've had to reflect and to be home and to you know, literally be with your family more than ever because of the fact that, you know, this has been a pandemic that has made us stay at home. And I think the things that has inspired me are my children. Need to say of how hard it's been. You, Nivea, have inspired me, my two boys. They really encouraged me to keep pressing, keep doing ministry, keep working hard. I also watch some really good pronoun speakers, prestigious speakers, and that has inspired me. Dr. Miles Monroe, if you guys watch some of his videos, he's a wonderful minister, theologist that passed away years ago, but his speaking and his teaching is still on in YouTube. And one of my friends during a very hard time for me sent me one of his teachings on kingdom. He's a kingdom ambassador. I'm a kingdom ambassador. I'd rather call myself a kingdom ambassador rather than a Christian, because Christianity is more consumed as a religion, but I'm more of a relationship follower, a kingdom ambassador. I'm a part of a government. And so I love how he teaches that. So that's what's inspired me since COVID. And that's what's been, you know, probably my strongest strength. So okay, that is the question. Say it again. Maybe you got to say the question again, please.
Okay. So my question is, what has, to all you Growing Black Women, men, and all the people out there, what was the most inspiring thing that has happened to you during COVID-19? I'm asking music that has inspired you as a woman or a man, music, people, events, just everything that has inspired you to do what you needed, what you were doing in your life, and inspired you to talk and express what your feelings are about this whole thing. Mm-hmm. What's going on?
You know, it's real early in the morning. I think people are still hungover from Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
So I don't know if anybody's even going to comment, but our next segment, you're going to have a dope question again. And so we're going to wait a little bit. But I think it's true. Like, you know, so what has inspired you, Nivea?
I could say that mostly the music and all the protesting that has happened that inspired me. Like, I noticed that in my generation, like, in 2020 and from 2009 to 2020, all of our music has been just all over the place, from good music to just flat out just cussing the whole time. And then there's just lots of songs that have told me that I am special. Mm. I'm a woman. I'm a powerful woman. I can do anything. Mm. I have people that will support me mm-hmm. in everything that I do. Mm-hmm. And there's a woman out there that have spoke and said that they can do anything too. They actually care mm-hmm. about the people in their lives. Mm-hmm. And I think the protesting as much has inspired lots of people, including me, mm-hmm. to fight for mm-hmm. the black culture mm-hmm. and that this is not right. Mm-hmm. Like one time when we were at the store, mm-hmm. some people just don't appreciate, they were just being racist, period, flat out, period. So we were at the store and you know how everybody has is just, I guess, has COVID-19, people are just scared of COVID-19. It's like in the beginning. Mm-hmm. So people were, social distancing. And we were right behind this line in this old lady, and she was talking. And then she turned around and said, back up 6 feet. And I'm like, we're already in line, ready to go. And she's just standing there doing stuff. And then my mom,
me.
You said, well, I don't have to move. I'm in my line.
Yeah, I was six feet apart.
And
yeah.
then she said, I don't care if you're colored or anything. I 6 feet apart. I in this COVID-19, yada, 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 nobody cares. And everybody was like, oh, heck.
She said,
I don't care about your color.
Yeah, don't care
and then color. Everybody looked at her and was like, dang, she's something wrong with her, and she run out. And my mom was like, I don't care what you say, I'm black, I'm beautiful, God made me this beautiful woman. And everybody is like, that's just wrong. I'm glad you said something about that.
I just wanted to add, thank you for telling us that story, because it was traumatically an experience of racism that's been going on for 400 years, and that my children had to see the truth of all the movies that they've seen, Malcolm X, Martin Luther King, all these videos. They watched a lot, just even Black Panther, just seeing the beautiful parts about being black, and they've watched it. I've taught them, and I study African-American studies since I studied it in college. But this is something that now finally became the reality. So when she was telling the story about when I was in line that time, that, you know, during this COVID-19, even though we had Thanksgiving and we have shared our love, there's still things that need to be cleaned out of our hearts in this country. And so, yes, I did go outside and tell that lady, though, but I did tell her as well, Navia, that I'm going to pray for her, and that Jesus changes her heart, that Jesus cleans out the sickness that's in her heart, because it's a sick heart to hate the image of God, that the way he created, and black people are the image of God.
Yeah.
And so at the end of the day, if you hate the image of God, you hate yourself, you know? So go ahead, talk more. Oh, please repeat your question. People are on right now, so maybe we'll get some comments.
Okay. My question is, what has inspired all of our black women and black men and all people, doesn't matter what you look like or what you do, what has inspired you? What music, what people, what events has inspired you to keep going during this COVID-19 and not give up on everything?
Praise God. Wonderful. Praise God. And as a Christian worldview, you know, this is what I talk about in these podcasts, is growing up black women, hot topics. And this is a hot topic, COVID-19 during Thanksgiving, COVID-19. But how important it is as a Christian to be, some people, you know, that consider themselves as Christians, we consider ourselves as kingdom ambassadors, but it's the same, quite the same values, but we don't see ourselves as religion. we see ourselves as a relationship, but as that belief and that faith as a kingdom ambassador, how are you taking this in? Has your life, have you been inspired, or have you just fell off and just gave into what the government is telling you to do, you know?
I could say that I have not given up. I've been inspired to act into being Black and being me and being what I want, doing what I want to do, not what everybody else tells me, not what the world tells me, being me. I think the what most inspired me was young women or girls as old as me going to protests or just being on podcasts or just making videos saying that I like being me. I like being my color, my skin. I don't care if I have eczema. I don't care if I have hyperpigmentation. I don't care if I have spots on me or just like lighter coloration of my skin. I'm Black. I have melanin. I'm beautiful. I can do any. I'm gonna say it again. I can do anything. I am smart. I'm beautiful. I am an entrepreneur.
Yes.
I think during this whole time, I felt like I can do better than I've ever done before. What I want to do is make technology, make the world better, and just explore. And I think during this time, I get that chance to do more of that and just be me and inspire other people to do that too.
I feel like you're seeing the newness and not being so concerned about what has been taken, but what you are going to take.
Yes. Now,
the newness of it. Like, people are so concerned, is like, oh, I can't do this, I can't do that more, but what can you do? Do what you can and amplify that, you know, go be on fire on that. Let the fire of God flame you to go after what you can do. And what the way I hear in your voice is that it has ignited you. And that's what Growing Young Black Woman is about. That's what our podcast, GYBW podcast, that's what you're on right now. That's what you're watching. Our podcast is to ignite you with the flame of fire that God has to, that the flame of fire that comes down from heaven, that fires you up in your gifts. And that's only from the kingdom of God. So Nivea, who are you?
I'm a child of God. I'm Esther. I am everything. I'm what God made me. I'm what God gave into me. I'm a child of God. I'm a split image of God. I just hope that I can inspire other girls to think that they're beautiful. They're made in the image of God. God loves them and they can do anything. And to all those girls out there who has second guessed themselves during the school time because people are just being critical and their teachers or just anybody's being critical to them during being at school, because I know I felt that being critical, and I had to second guess myself when I did stuff like art, people would just be mean because they knew that I was good and I wanted to be nice, but they just be mean. I was smart. I was in kindergarten when I was four. I didn't know a lot, but I knew a lot for a four-year-old. Mm-hmm. People were just mean. So now that we don't have school, I think that's just better for us, mm-hmm. that we don't have to be critical. So all those girls out there who had to stop doing their stuff that they love because people were being just super, having superstitions about them, like, oh my gosh, what if they be better than me? I shouldn't let them do this. Mm-hmm. You can do it now. Nobody can say anything about it. So if girls want to model, you can do it now. Just take a picture of yourself on social media. If you want to sing, you can get on YouTube and make yourself like a character, and nobody has to even know it's you. Mm-hmm. You can draw, nobody has to know it's you. Mm-hmm. And then at the end, you can say, well, for all those people who would be mean to me and didn't appreciate that I wanted to be friends with them, but they didn't appreciate what I could do, take look at this and say that, wow, I should have been friends with them. I should have been nicer to them. Mm-hmm. It's just things that you can do on your own, mm-hmm. with God, mm-hmm. that will improve everything in your life, oh, that wow. make you so much better,
wow.
and like just help you in all the things that you do.
Praise God.
That the people who are mean to you, they can't say nothing now.
Right.
You're not, you can talk back to them. They can't say nothing.
Well, praise God, Nivea. Thank you for that. And what was the question that we're asking? Everybody on Facebook Live right now, she has a question from, this is a segment of Growing Young Black Women. And we have a part or GYBW a podcast that we're doing right now that the young women get on, and Nivea is the GYBW ambassador that comes on our segment every time and asks us a question on Facebook Live of what she feels a young woman's heart is asking everybody right now. So please say the question again and see if we get any comments.
Okay, I want to ask all people, anybody who it is, what inspired you the most during COVID-19? That's my this is the most important question that I need to get out of it. What inspired you to keep going, to not give up on everything and just sit there and do nothing and just let it all go through? Why did you not let anybody talk you into being alone all day, doing nothing, not going outside and
quarantine.
Quarantine with everybody else, or just going outside to say, you don't have to be right next to them. You don't have to be all up on top of them. You just come right here, at least a little space between them. You say, hi, mm-hmm. I'm sorry that things happened during this time. I wasn't thinking what I needed to do, or just anything that you needed to say. Well, I'm sorry for everything that has happened. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. I'm glad that you're my friend. I'm glad that you're here with me. Right. I'm glad
that
you're.
Thanksgiving inspired people this time during COVID-19 too. Is that a form of being inspired right now too? Do you think people are being inspired because of Thanksgiving now, because they see the importance of family now?
Yeah, I think that even though some people might say that, well, you shouldn't go see your family. COVID-19, you don't need to see them. You're going to get sick. That's not going to happen. They're your family. As long as you have God with you, you can see them. If they're at the country, don't do that. You don't have to do that. You can just Zoom them. If they're right next door to you, you go see them. You don't have to be, you can do all the procedures that you need to do, but at least go reconcile or go see your family and just clear things up between all of your family. During this time, I think this is the best time that you can go see your family and see what they need. And all of your the people who have died during this COVID-19, I pray that they go to heaven. They think about their choices and they remember that God is a forgiving God. He will always remember what you do. And I pray in Jesus' name that they remember. And you remember them. You remember what they did, and remember that you're always praying for the people that you love. Remember, even though they're gone, doesn't mean that you have to forget what they helped you do throughout your life, or helped you remember even after somebody's gone. They help you remember that there's something better going on even though they're gone. I know that people might still be mourning for the people who had died, but God's gonna give you something better. Even though they died, it's all for a reason. You always have to just trust God. Just always remember that.
Well, her question again is for you guys on Facebook, and we're about to get off of live, but we haven't had any comments, but I was able to respond to, but she asked the question one more time.
Okay, so what has inspired you throughout this whole COVID-19 and social distancing and Black Lives Matter? What has inspired you during this whole time? What has inspired you to keep on going, not to give up on life and the whole point of it? Has get you to do more stuff, but get more stuff, do more stuff for your family, or do more stuff for the community? What has inspired you to do that?
All right. So we haven't seen any comments, but this is GYBW podcast live on Facebook today, this morning, the day after Thanksgiving. The topic of this segment was pretty much cleaning after Thanksgiving. And so as we know that we have to literally clean our houses after Thanksgiving, but we also know that we have to clean also our house, your temple. And what things have been brought up with your family, with your friends, and what's inside your heart, that needs to get cleaned out too during this time. Any issues or any frustrations you have with other people, and that to let it go, forgive, clean it out so you can have a clean plate.
so you can have a clean house on the inside. And so also, this is another thing that the question of a young Black woman, Nevaeh Shepherd, our ambassador, has just brought. What has inspired you during this COVID-19 so you could keep going? And that's another way to keep your house clean, is being inspired. So we thank you so much for being with us live on Facebook. We see all you guys that came and watched. It is early in the morning. We got some cleaning to do, right?
We're gonna clean house today.
Oh my gosh. Can we go to the store first?
We're gonna go and clean house. You guys have a wonderful Thanksgiving. Thank you for watching our podcast. Thank you for being here. And so we just want to end, and I'm gonna share my screen, and we're gonna be grateful. We're back. We're gonna be out on. We're gonna come back on our third. This is our second episode of GYBW, and so we are just grateful to have you guys on. And we say, growing young Black woman, keep on your crown. Bye.
Let's finish. Oh wow. I'm so tired.
Yo.